So you want to make money online reselling, but what does it take to actually become a successful reseller? I've been reselling for years and I actually did it full-time for a little while. So today I'm going to share some of my best tips to have a successful reselling business. Hi, my name is Eileen. Welcome to Hustle and Slow, where I talk all about making money from home for regular people and building multiple streams of income. I truly believe that anybody can make money at home. I actually support my family full-time making money from home through several streams of income, and I'm not anyone special, and I think that anybody can do it. So this channel actually started as a reselling channel, and now I talk about all different types of ways to make money from home, but I do have a lot of content about reselling. So even though I'm taking a break from reselling because I am living in a travel trailer and traveling full-time with my family and we don't have room for a bunch of inventory, I did want to take some time to talk about what it takes to have a successful reselling business. So I'm going to give you my best tips and let's go. Before I start, don't forget to like this video and subscribe if you want to see more videos about reselling, making money from home, and building multiple streams of income. So the first thing is to keep your business finances or your reselling finances separate from your personal finances. So this means not using your personal checking account, your debit card, your credit card, or your reselling business, and having a totally separate way to pay for things and a separate bank account for your income to go into. So you can just open a personal checking account. It doesn't necessarily have to be a business checking account as far as I know, and just have a debit card for that and use that for your reselling business so that all of your transactions for your business are within one account. This makes it so much easier to know what you're spending, what you're making, and it also makes it a lot easier at tax time when you need to kind of go through all of your transactions and see what your income and expenses are. If everything is all mixed in with your personal finances, it's really hard to keep track of it, and most banks are going to allow you to have an extra checking account, just open an extra checking account for free, or have a minimum balance or something like that in order for it to be for free. But either way, it's really easy to just get a separate checking account and keep all your business finances in there. The next thing is to know your numbers. I cannot tell you, it is shocking how many resellers don't know their numbers. They don't know how much they're making on each item, their income and expenses each month, how much they should be paying themselves, stuff like that. So knowing your numbers is really important to being successful, because if you don't know your numbers and how much profit you're making, how do you even know you're making a profit? Maybe you're just wasting your time and you're not making enough money to really take a profit and pay yourself fairly. In the reseller dashboard, which is an Airtable spreadsheet, you can track your inventory and you can also track your sales so that you can see how much you're making on each item. This really helps you see how much profit you're making on items to make sure you're actually making a profit. And it also helps you with your sourcing decisions moving forward, because if you notice that certain items really aren't making you as much profit as you thought, you know to skip those next time. Next up, you want to make sure that you save money for taxes. If you're making an income, at least in the United States, you're going to have to pay taxes on that income. While I am not a licensed tax professional, and you should definitely talk to one yourself, if you do a quick Google search, it tells you to save 30 to 35% of your taxable income for taxes. So having a separate account where you can just put money in to save for taxes at tax time is a really good idea. You don't want to be at the point where you owe taxes on your income and you don't have that money to pay. So you have to clearance a bunch of your items in order to just pay your tax bill. Next up, you want to make sure that you create systems and streamline as much as possible. Your time is worth money and you don't want to spend more time doing tasks than you have to. Even if you love every single part of reselling, creating systems in the way that you do things will save you time, make you more efficient, and make sure that you don't make mistakes. For example, if you have a system for what you do when you come home from sourcing, let's say you go to the thrift store, what do you do when you get home? You just kind of throw everything in a pile and wait to list it later? Or can you come up with a system where you neatly lay things out so that you don't have to steam them later because they're not just sitting in a bag getting wrinkled, and you immediately put how much money you spent in your spreadsheet, and then you put those items in inventory so that they're ready to go and you have a nice pile of items that are nicely laid out for photos later. Coming up with different systems for the different things that you do frequently in your business is going to save you a lot of time. Make sure you don't miss any steps, and just kind of helps you with decision fatigue so you always know what you need to be doing. So for example, if you're taking photos, you know exactly what steps to take photos because you're following a certain system. So write down what you do now when you take photos, when you come home from sourcing, or anything that you do regularly, and make sure that you have steps that you follow, and then you can always tweak that later and continually improve your processes and your systems so that you're doing things more quickly and more organized and more efficiently, and then your business is running really well. This next one is really important, and that is to source well. We have all fallen into the cheap and cute trap, and I want to tell you, do not fall for the cheap and cute trap. If it's cheap and cute, if it's not gonna sell, and there's no proof that it's going to sell when you do research, don't buy it just because it's cheap and it's cute. Make sure that you are only spending your time and money sourcing products that are going to actually bring you a good profit. Don't guess, don't hope. Only buy things that you know will bring you a profit, and this will help your business so much. Sourcing well is one of the biggest keys to having a good reselling business or a successful reselling business, because if you aren't sourcing well, you are wasting your time and your money on products that aren't going to bring you much profit. And then of course you're going to want to keep your inventory organized. When you first get started, keeping a bin of a few items in your closet or hanging a few things in your closet is fine when you have maybe 10, 15, 20 items. But once you get to the point where you have 50, 100, 500, 1,000 items, you really want to be more organized so that you can quickly find things, you don't lose things, and things don't get damaged. My preference is to have shelves in the garage with labeled bins, and then within those labeled bins, each item has its own item number. And then I put that into the listing so that I can quickly find items. I actually have a video right here that I will link down below about how I keep my inventory organized, so you can check that out after this video. The next thing is, don't get attached to your inventory. Even professional resellers make bad buying decisions, or the market changes and something is suddenly not worth what it was worth before and they have to sell it at a loss. And I've actually had comments on YouTube where I talked about this on a previous video and someone was saying, she's telling you to sell at a loss. That's terrible advice. But here's the thing. If you buy something and then 6 months goes by and the market is no longer there for it, what are you going to do? You're just going to hold on to it forever? Sometimes you're going to have to take that loss, just get that item out, and keep the money rolling. I'm not saying to clearance all of your inventory, but sometimes things decrease in value, or you just buy something that isn't worth much and you just have to take a loss occasionally. So that's just something that happens. That's business. Even large corporations have to do this every once in a while. So don't worry about it if it happens to you. Just take that mistake and learn from it and move on. And the last one is to make sure that you pay yourself. There are so many resellers that I've talked to that don't pay themselves regularly. They say that they just take a little bit of money here and there, or they buy themselves some items when they're at the thrift store with the money that they make reselling, and they just really don't have a system or process or amount that they pay themselves regularly. At the beginning, fine, reinvest everything back into your business, take your profit and get more inventory. But if you're a year into this, you need to be paying yourself. You need to be treating this as a business, and you need to be paying yourself fairly for the work that you're doing. If you're having trouble finding the money to pay yourself because you aren't quite sure how much to pay yourself or where to get the money from to pay yourself because you're spending all your money on inventory, then I really recommend the book Profit First. I recommend it in like almost every video because it really changed the way that I did my business finances, and now I'm able to pay myself more than a fair income and support my family. Being a successful reseller and having a successful reselling business is not just about being able to list quickly and find good items to sell. There's a lot more that goes into it, and you want to treat this business like a real business. Hopefully you learned something new that will help you have a more successful reselling business. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more videos from me about making money from home, reselling, and building multiple streams of income. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.